No,
just a
wait,
minute.
wait, 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 sir. Wait, sir.
Yeah.
I will tell you to start, sir. Please wait.
Sure. I will go out of the box a little bit.
No problem. Take your own time.
Ah, sir. Okay.
Yes, Anu, we are good to go.
Yes, thank you, Vineet. Kind information to participant, kindly mute your audio and disable your video, and please don't annotate on the screen while the presentation is going on. Thank you. Good afternoon to one and all. With the blessings of our founder chancellor, Colonel Dr. Japia, sir, I am happy to welcome you for the virtual symposium on the recent trends in aquaculture industries, jointly organized by Colonel Dr. JPR Research Park, Center for Ocean Research, and Satyabhama University Technology Business Incubator in association with Ministry of Earth Science and Technology Cell. On behalf of Center for Ocean Research, we sincerely express our heartfelt thankfulness to our Honorable Chancellor Madam, Dr. Maria Zina Johnson, and our President Sir, Dr. Mary Johnson, for their constant guidance, support, and encouragement in conducting this virtual symposium. Now it is the time to welcome Dr. D. Inbagandan, Head, Center for Ocean Research, and the today's guest speaker, Dr. Maria Raj Vijay, Director, Best Aquaster Shrimp Hatcheries, Proprietor, Arcone Life Science, for the sixth day afternoon session of the virtual symposium. M. Vijay, a marine biotechnologist, postgraduate Master of Science and Master of Philosophy in Marine Biotechnology in Mannon Maniyam Sundaranar University, and submitted PhD thesis in Marine Biotechnology Aquaculture in University of Madras. He has over 18 years of wide technical experience as technical service expert in almost all branches of aquaculture. Currently, Dr. M. Vijay is the director of Best Aquastar Shrimp Hatcheries, Marakkanam, Tamil Nadu, and proprietor of Arcone Life Science, Puducherry, and Arcone Laboratories, Contai, West Bengal, and technical advisor of KNC Agro Group, West Bengal. He had started a career with Hiravati Marine Products Private Limited, Porbandar, Gujarat, as a technologist, then worked with CP Aquaculture India Private Limited, Chennai, as a technician, hatchery and feed marketing. Worked with Tablets India Limited, Chennai, as a technical service executive. He had owned and operated Maria Aqua Services in Andhra Pradesh, Kerala, and Tamil Nadu for providing consultancy services to the shrimp and fish farmers, and worked with Rajshri Biosolutions, Coimbatore, Tamil Nadu, as the head of aquaculture market operation, and established its market across India as well as in neighboring countries of India. He was one of the founder members of this organization. M. Vijay had done a research work entitled Reviving Shrimp Ponds Under Disuse in India, an Ecological Economics Approach, which was appreciated by aquaculture professional across India as it's one of the significant research works to elevate Indian aquaculture, has been carried out under the guidance of Dr. T. Ravishankar, Principal Scientist, SAIBA, and to be submitted shortly for the award of doctoral degree in University of Madras. With pride and immense pleasure, we welcome Dr. Maria Raj Vijay to give the talk on aquaculture career and opportunities. A warm welcome you, sir. The session is over to you, sir.
Vijay, sir, you can proceed, please.
Okay. Manakam. So, good afternoon, everyone. This is Vijay from Pondicherry. Actually, first of all, I would like to congratulate Dr. Inbagandan for organizing what has been such a very nice event, scientific event, for the past 5 days, bringing several aquacultural intellectuals. So Mr. Dr. Manoj Sharma and Dr. Cheran and Victor Suresar, Dr. Fashad, and my brothers, Dr. Kadravan and Dr. Selva Kumar, and few more people. So it's a nice and wonderful event is actually being organized. And at the same time, I would like to thank Dr. Inbagandan for inviting me to give you a small lecture about the current aquaculture and current aquaculture and its trends. So, apart from that, I would like to thank the organizing institute, Satyabhama University, for a wonderful steps, which is a wonderful initiative to boost the aquaculture. For contributing aquacultural activities. Okay. The first of all, The topic I have chosen is something different from the mainstream. So when everybody talk about trends, technologies, and all those the related things, I just got diverted and have chosen career and opportunities. Though it is very important for this for the entire industry. So I would like to get into this. The first two, first of all, as I said earlier, though it is something different from the current trends, it's a value thing, and it's a time, it's a hour of need. The targeted people in the particular symposium, I believe more than 50% of people are from student community. It is my duty to let you guys know that how big this industry and how much potential it has. Since I'm a man, business entrepreneur, so this is my duty, to let some people, at least some people of you, some people of from different sectors, or even it's aquaculture and fishery sector, to get into this aquaculture industry. The thing is that actually, you see, there are a lot of things and steps that we need to talk about. First, we are getting into the career and opportunity. It's a simple thing, but thing is that to know how big this industry, how much potential this industry has, it's very important. So that's why actually, you see, I would like to elaborate what are the opportunities and career opportunities are available in front of you in aquaculture as well as fisheries. In India, you can see, the east coast and west coast is a vast coastal line we have. Almost 18 kilometers of this coastal line, and we are blessed with those coastal lines, which is very suitable for aquaculture activities. Just a second. Actually, this is these are the things actually we are going to have.
Yes, sir.
So the coastal line, as I said, 18 kilometers long. We are blessed with that, in that actually, so you would like to. You have to know that the estuarine area, the that is actually 3.9 million hectares. The 3.9 million, of which 1.2 million hectares of salt affected area, which is very, very suitable for shrimp farming, and 0.58 hectares of aquaculture, that area can be used for aquaculture purpose. So in addition to this, coastal mangroves areas are almost 0.5 million hectares, which actually lies in West Bengal, Orissa, and a few parts of Tamil Nadu, very well. Actually, Pichavaram and all those areas is suitable for the crab culture also, since it has a mangroves area. In the freshwater area, if you look at that, 2.2 million hectares of fresh water ethan ponds are available, which can be utilized for freshwater aquaculture. Then lakes and reservoirs, very well, we have actually blessed, India is blessed with a lot and lots of lakes and reservoirs. It is comes around to 2.09 million hectares. Particularly, in this brackish water aquaculture, I would like to tell you one thing. The West Bengal and Gujarat states, they are highly blessed than other states. They have very good high tidal amplitude. So by having this, they can go, they are in the, the process of leading the country in shrimp aquaculture. So there are 2.2 million, 2.3 million hectares of abundant paddy fields, which can be used for fish culture. And actually, surprisingly, you know, I think you may be knowing that there are 9 million hectares of salt affected areas, and saline groundwater reserves are actually available in Haryana, Rajasthan, Punjab, Uttar Pradesh, Maharashtra, and Gujarat. So it is a very big, it's a very big reserve. I would like to tell you. So shrimp, actually, it is very suitable to, it is actually really suitable to culture those crustaceans. Personally, I have visited a few places in Punjab and Haryana. So those areas actually now have started shrimp culture. Venami shrimp is the PL I'm telling you. It's being exported to shipped to Punjab from Marganam area. So the desert aquaculture, you know, so it's like Middle East countries. We also have started very recently. The trial is going on in Rajasthan desert. It's actually a good thing. It's a very, it gives very good scope. Look at the table of the potential versus under culture. See, as I said earlier, West Bengal and Gujarat have very good potential. Look at 2013. And 2018, in the 5 years, there is actually 25% of increase in a farming area. There is an important call. The farming area actually increased by 25% from 2013 to 2018. It was 1.3 lakhs in 2013 and 1.6 and 7 in 2017. The area utilized, since the average percentage of utilized is very, very, very less, 13.66 only. Moreover, actually, there are some data, either unofficial data, showing that in 40% of unregistered farms are there. So still 11.9 lakh of areas actually not yet utilized. Fully, completely utilized, not utilized. The contribution of our aquaculture and fisheries is huge to the GDP. The agriculture's GDP is 5.23 to the GDP is 2.3, of which the aquaculture alone contributes 1.62. It's a big thing, you know. So that's why actually we proudly say that we feed the world, and we are very one of the very important pillars in building Indian economy. 1.62, and it generates almost 14 million of jobs. Surprisingly, in Indian aquaculture, if I look at that, the small landholders plays very big role. So 95% of farmers are small landholders. They have actually less than 2 hectares only. Okay, and the rest of 5 to 10%, you know, that is actually 2.2 to 5 hectares. The corporate farms which we usually talk about is really very less. The contribution to the entire production is actually coming from the small scale industry only. That means small scale farm only. The production and export. See, look at the jump from 2018 to 2019. So 2 lakhs ton actually. See, it is actually 31% shrimp production. It's a remarkable things actually we have achieved. the export got 8% to various countries, it increased, and the shrimp alone represented 83% in 2019. In the pandemic time, actually before starting that in March, through March 2020, about actually we have produced 2.3 lakh metric ton shrimp we have produced. Out of that, 78%, you know, that is actually got exported to the global market. Why does aquaculture matter? Why should we take aquaculture as a career, or we have to treat it as an opportunity? See, look at this slide. Just 14% increase has been recorded in the from the global capture fish production from almost 30 years, 1992 to 2018, almost 30 years. But when you look at the global aquaculture production, it's actually it goes like a rocket speed, 527% it actually it gone to that. At the same time, parallelly, the fish consumption, you know, that also day by day on daily basis, it goes up, plus 122%. So see, look at the, if you look at that slide, you can come to know how big this market is and how important market is. Why should we take this aquaculture fisheries as a career? Of course, it generates a huge employment. So these two, aquaculture and fisheries, put together generate almost, as I said earlier, it generates a huge employment. In that, globally, if you look at that, 59.5 million people were engaged in both primary and primary sector of fisheries and aquaculture. Aquaculture alone, 20.5 million people are employed, and fisheries 39%. It is just a slighter slight increase from 2017, but majority of the workforce is being supplied by Asia only, we ourselves, 85%. So still I have a lot to talk about the same stuff which we are talking about. To meet the actually day by day the demand for the animal protein, you know, it's actually goes up. You cannot imagine how much we need in another 100 years. But in 2020 we need at least 196 million tons of animal protein. But currently we stand at, I think, almost 170 million tons of protein. So how we are going to fill up the gap? Already the current depletion rate of marine stock is actually almost next to impossible. So that means that the bucket, you know, that the marine stock bucket is almost actually gone. So we need to fill up that gap. Who can come and fill up the gap? So aquaculture is the only option which can fill up the gap. So India has the chance. India has the potential to bridge the gap if we concentrate on aquaculture, since we have very good potential. So there are a lot of ways and opportunities and options through which you can my language, I can say, to fill up the gap. You can take, these are the option opportunity. You can take as a business, like shrimp culture, fin fish culture, seaweed culture, crab, lobster, mussel, clams, and you people know very well about it. From hatchery background, so I would like to tell you two things. The one actually, the one is polychaet culture, you know, and artemia and oyster culture. So every day on daily basis, we import lot and huge quantity of artemia from overseas, America or another Taiwan or Vietnam and all those foreign countries. Our Indian money, you know, we are pumping like anything. So we need to stop this. So we have to not, it is not possible 100%, but we have to try. We 100% of, I can say 100% of the purchase is being done to actually in the name of foreign companies only. So if you concentrate, if people take artemia culture as a career or opportunity or anything else, you know, it will be a best help to induce the Indian economy. So artemia, polycarp, these two, and you know, so the feed also, actually, see, mainly the hatchery said, you know, we spent lot of money for a lot of money on shrimp feeds, artemia and polycarps to feed the brooders and PL. So almost 80% of those inputs we are purchasing from the foreign conditions. So we need to stop. So my request is, it's a high time, it's a hour of need to do something for that. So one can take integrated aqua farms, along with the agriculture, livestock, and other poultry business, you can do this also. Fish and shrimp hatchery. So you cannot go, if you are not in the position to spend more money, at least you can start back at finfish, fish hatcheries, and feed meal and fish feed industry is a big one. It needs huge amount of the capital, but still there is an opportunity to get into this process and pre-processing. You need to designate actually pre-processing units, establishing a pre-processing units doesn't need a huge amount, but still you can select that. Seafood logistics, you can. And value added product is actually, it's nothing, you know, is but so you, we can say jam, dried fish, pickled, and a few businesses which need, which actually don't need huge quantity of money for the investment. As usual, actually, there are some cultivable biological sources, okay, which you can take as a business. Finfishes, shrimps, first finfishes, sea bass, pearl spot, and Ephenopolis, grouper, millfishes, you know, sea bass. Sea bass actually the technology of this one, you know, the breeding culturing of that sea bass is done by SIBA, where I done my research work. Dr. Arasu, such a very what do you say, there is nowhere to explain about him, such a very big genius, and he has done very big role in spreading this sea bass culture throughout India. So sea bass can be cultured in polyculture system. Okay, it gives really very good input also, output also. So sea bass one can definitely take. Actually the technology is with SIBA. You can get the tie up with them and actually you can move on. And few more species also you can culture. Crab, one of the commercially valuable species you can culture. These two, Scilla serrata and Scilla tangobaria, is highly valuable crops, which is being practiced. The culture of this one actually being practiced in Kerala, Karnataka, and Tamil Nadu area. Especially, you see, if you go and visit Palavarkad, Pulikadi area, you know, most of the ST people, that means those people are actually getting benefit by culturing these crops. Actually, the people are calling them irregular actually the community, you know, so they are doing very good you know things in crab fattening. Crab fattening is nothing actually. They're holding large crabs, large sized crabs that have recently molted. The recently molted, you know, you have to collect the recent crabs and holding the large size still 10 to 13 days until it becomes hard. Then it is actually attainable size to market. So once it's actually it becomes attainable size, and then you can definitely market the crab. It has really very good market value. Shrimps, actually several people talked about shrimp, and you know, you must you actually might be knowing about this. So you actually you are very well known. I think you are completely known about the shrimps, how to culture the shrimps and all this thing. So I'm not going to kill your time. So let escape. Seaweed, you know, seaweed is a very good business. You can definitely take up as a career. See, there are few areas in India, especially in the southern southeast coast of Tamil Nadu, Gujarat coast, Lakshadweep, Andaman, Nicobar Islands, where you can see luxuriant growth of green, brown, and red algae. I think yesterday, Dr. Jay Kumar has covered almost, I think, it's in every corner of this seaweed farming and its uses and all. So I'm not going to get into this deeply. So even though I'm going to touch a few points only, seaweeds, but the luxuriant and the fairy growth of seaweeds, you can see at Mumbai, Ratnagiri, Karwar, go in this actually in the west coast, you can see the luxuriant growth of the population of seaweed birds. In addition to this, coast lakes like Silka and Pulikat also have it. So coastal aquaculture, actually, you see, in the coastal region, I can give you an example how this seafood feeds those fisher folks. In Gulf of Mannar and Palk Bay, there are almost 38 coastal villages known to harvest seaweed. It's a seasonal work they are doing. Once the season gets over and ends, they will switch to other fishing activities. Almost, I think, approximately one person can earn $1,000 or $1,500 per annum. So it is a natural, the collection is being done in natural only, so no need to invest in anything. So usually the seaweed, you know, it is being used for the production of phycocolloids, including agar, alginate, carrageenan, and other purposes. Okay, so how they are processing and how it gets value, its value. So the value of look at the value of gelidia, you know, it's a dried gelidia. 1 ton of gelidia is 1,800 rupees, and this Crassularia sargassum and the Turbinaria, you know, this seaweed, you know, it is lesser than the gelidia, since the components is somewhat highly value one when compared to Crassularia and the sargassum. It is actually the $800. Actually, before the phase of seaweed culture in India got completely changed. The scenario got changed after the introduction of kappa beakers. So, because you know fastest growing seaweed, and it has a lot of lot of potential to use as a thickener emulsifier binder and other those things. It is actually being used for the toothpaste, cosmetics, ice cream and all those things. Okay. The commercial cultivation actually started in 2001. Actually, by Pepsi India Holding. Actually, this it is the culture of Papaya Senior started in I think so before 2001. Yeah, by Dr. Iswaran, you know, who is the principal scientist in CSMSRI, Mars. Marine Algal Research Station in Mandavam camp. Actually, he actually imported a few, it's a small mass of biomass of kappa bikers from Japan and started trialing. And I think he succeeded after the lot of trials, a lot of trial. And he come to, he found a lot of the variety of ways to culture the kappa bikers. So the CSMSRI, you know, they have done the technological transfer to Pepsi India Holdings. The Pepsi India, you know, that actually done a very good job. They initiated the buyback system with the self-help groups to uplift their socio-economic status. So the CSMSRI's role in kappa bikers and Indian aquaculture, Indian seaweed cultivation, you know, it's marvelous. The seaweed, it has another potential also. It acts as a biofertilizer and immunostimulants, which can be used in even aquaculture and agriculture. Being used in the broad spectrum of products such as food, this point we have already discussed. And this, you know, come to the biofuel. The next next 10 or 20 years, you know, we have to depend on the fuels, you know. So the so that's why actually government has taken the initiative to blend 20% of biofuels by 2030. So in that initiative, so Alva species, Alva kappa bikers species, Crassularia, Gelidium, and Sargassum species can contribute for biofuel. From that, actually, we can extract the biofuel. So based on the policy, the National Biofuel Policy of India, which is targeting 20% of blending of biofuels by 2030. So it is estimated that if you want to achieve that, you have to harvest 460 million tons of fresh seaweed biomass from 10 million hectares. And that is actually 5% of our exclusive, 5% of the area I'm telling you. So the 5% of total exclusive economic zone of India. And then only it could generate 6.6 million and the billion liters of bioethanol, which can meet, I think, 20% of blending biofuels by 2030. The pearl oyster farming, so it's an untapped sector which we are we have not yet utilized. The how to culture the pearl oyster in the controlled environment, that technical breakthrough was achieved in 1973 by CMFRI at Tuticorin. Then again, the same, that equally important and significant breakthrough was achieved in the controlled production of pearl oyster in the hatchery done in 1981. So after that, in 1981, from 1981 to till date, actually there is no there are yeah, I can say a few number of research findings only to how to culture commercially this PL oysters. So very recently I came to know that there is a success story actually from Kerala, Mr. Mathachan Kasaragod, Kerala. He has done marvelous work. Actually, it trigger people actually to do the PL oyster culture. See, he has spent just 1.5 lakhs of investment, and within 18 months of time, he produced almost 4.5 lakhs worth of PL and got 3 lakhs of profit. See the percentage of profit. So this is one of the sector you can definitely get in, and most of them are these the produced, you know, it actually got exported to Australia. It's being exported to Australia, Saudi Arabia, Kuwait, and Switzerland. For your kind information, the real PL would cost around 3,000 per carat and 1,800 per gram. So since that cosmetic and this you know other sector is actually other sectors are other means the film industry like that, you know, they need the support from this kind of business. This is the way how he cultured and he is culturing freshwater PL oyster. So actually it looks really nice, you know. It's a simple technology he is using, okay. So in the backyard itself, he is actually in his backyard itself, he is culturing it, and the harvested freshwater PL oyster. So since the opportunity, you know, the opportunity is not gender based normally, and gender based still be actually women are not permitted to assess their opportunity. So actually my point being from the aquaculture background, so I believe women's participation in aquaculture and fisheries, it is very important to achieve the superpower India. So in this contest, I wanted to let you know where the women is. Some issues on my side.
What happened, sir?
Yeah, no, actually we had a network issue. That's why I'm not okay. So the people may think that it's out of box, but see, within the box only, actually I would like to tell, I would like to explain how women is very important to this aquaculture and the fishery sectors. So the FIO figures tells that women account for just 14% only. So I have some disturbance.
So we can see your slide clearly, sir.
Yeah, I'm not able to see the first line of my slides.
Okay.
That's why actually I get stuck.
Okay.
It has to come down or so whenever
it is,
somebody
is clear. The thing is, it's very clearly visible to all of us, audience.
So here in the scene, so there is a box. It repeatedly showing that somebody is entering the waiting room for this meeting. So admit.
Okay, sir.
We will take care of that. We will take care of that.
Yeah. So,
One yes, minute, sir. Did it make it into your own control?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay, make it.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Done, sir. Done, sir.
Thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. So sorry for the disturbance, actually.
No problem, sir.
So the FIO my reports tells that actually the women account just 14% out of 59.9 million people engaged in the primary sector of fisheries and aquaculture. But that women studies and other NGO people actually reporting that one out of two workers are women. Still, I have some issues.
Again, it is coming to you.
Box is not coming, but the right side, you know, we people, we three are, you know, that.
That is, I think, speaker, you can go to the speaker view, sir.
That's a good thing, actually. See, but,
yeah, please.
So how to do it, Dr. Kandan?
Yeah, actually, it will be on the top right corner, sir. You will see an option called speaker view or thumbnail view like that. Can you see that?
Hide thumbnail video.
Yes, sir. You can click on that.
Yeah, that's a good. Thank you. Yes. See. So the FOO figure, you know, it tells that the woman account for just 14% of total 59.5 million people engaged in primary sector of fisheries and aquaculture. And the instead of that, actually, when comparing, many others, and the women in the women studies and the some NGOs, they are reporting that one out of two women, the workers are women. They are stating like this. So almost 50% of workers are from a women community. Okay. Women provides labor in both commercial and traditional fisheries and act as a small scale entrepreneurs when the capital allows. However, that you know that still the women plays unstable roles and they are getting paid very less amount. Even sometimes they are not paid in the proper way. And those positions, you know, it requires lower qualifications. Most of them in the secondary sector. Most of them are say in secondary sector only, and those are under recognized or not recognized at all in sector. This is status of women in aquaculture and fisheries sector in various countries. So in Indian scenario is something different from other countries. So look at the slide, the Bangladesh, so I have listed few more countries. In the Bangladesh, you know, they get very good support from NGOs and other entrepreneurs. They are encouraging the farmers and the women community to engage in aquaculture activities. In Belize, majority of the women are involved in the processing site. Since they are from a rural community and the poverty is high in those rural areas. Cuba, it seems very good numbers, which concerns the women, constitute 27% of the aquaculture force. Jamaica, actually, the 8 to 11% of women who own fish farms and other things. Malaysia, 10% of workforce are into this aquaculture activity. They are women involved in freshwater aquaculture and hatchery operations for marine and freshwater fish and shrimps. In Panama, actually 80% of the workforce in processing plants, but in the production sector, just 7% only. Our neighboring country, Sri Lanka, it has just 5% only. And 30% of women force, they are engaged in production and breeding of ornamental fishes. So the surprisingly and the positive things is we are observing from Israel, the 95% of the workforce is belongs to this women community, since they are skilled one, because highly technical knowledge of aquaculture they have. Status of Indian woman in aquaculture and fisheries. So in Indian woman, you know, so in India, so the women are known to play the roles that are household related, fisheries related, and in research development. So they are actually completely and dedicatedly they are working on that only. So in the house related household related, you know very well, you know very well, if fisheries related, that they do marketing, pre-processing, processing, and a restricted role in harvest. Again, the woman, you know, so though the woman constitute approximately half of Indian population, play a vital role in operation of fisheries. They have actually the contribution of fisher women, you know, it is observed a few years in few areas in harvest sector, and more predominantly in post-harvest activities, which includes handling, preservation, processing, and marketing of seafood products, and provides an integral link between producers and consumers. Still, the women community is limited to assess resources and opportunities. And this is being observed that they are not adequately represented the leader position. So the data about that women is completely scarce, and even is not available. If it is available, it is poor quality, not covering all the sections adequately. So women, actually women's participation is often constrained by strong cultural rules, some communal conventions also. Well, the future growth of fisheries industry, you know, it is expected to come from the fishing activities. So where women who can enter fish production in developing countries, actually still like they are fighting for to own even a boat or land. So the as usual, the next point is actually clearly states that limited access to loans. You cannot get the loan if the bank or any funding agency, and they may think that actually you are not capable the stuff enough to handle that business. So the limit, you know, so the access to access to the loans, it is completely different from male when compared to this one. So you cannot get the easy, but you know, we have to knock the door again and again and get the loan. The problem of gender inequality, it is completely not, it's not only limited in small scale fisheries in developing countries, it is also reflected in the relative absence of women in boardrooms, executive position, and fisheries conference. It's true, I think you might be, actually we are witnessing it. Women in harvester sector, harvesting activities visible in hinterland, inland water bodies. This is actually, you see, to support the household nutrient requirements, they are doing it. The women are actually committed to do it. And some area, you know, in Orissa and West Bengal, the people, the women community actually are engaged in collecting shrimp seeds and crabs from intertidal region of Eshwari and other parts. None of the harvesting activities, you know, are large scale, and this is not comparable with the fishermen. So the fisherman, you know, so whatever the harvest activities he does, it is not comparable with a women's vision. In the post-harvest sector, in India, you know, not only India, the entire across the globe, the predominant in the post-harvest fisheries sector is it's completely the women is actually women occupies the entire post-harvest sector, engaged in marketing, drying, smoking, salting, fermenting, and other seafood industry oriented pre-processing and processing. And 50-70% of them and their family are dependent on fresh fish marketing and traditional fish processing for their livelihoods. And in the southern states, you know, the 50-70% of the people are people and their families are dependent on fresh fish marketing only. In Lakshadweep, there is a place there's Minikai. There, actually, the major tuna based fisheries product, these three, you know, is being handled by the women only. Women in aquaculture farming. The reason, actually, so why the contribution of women in aquaculture is limited? The reason is the location of aquaculture sites in remote area. Also, several socio cultural taboos. Okay. So they are strictly involved in pond preparation, stocking, feeding, and harvesting along with men. So they cannot do it in, they are not doing it alone. So along with women, they are doing it. And the ownership of a farm, you know, is still largely male dominated. So women can be seen engaged in carp breeding and rearing, carp polyculture, ornamental fish breeding, fish preparation, and the culture of this spirulina and azolla. So in West Bengal, there are some places where ornamental fish breeding is being done by women. And there are some women, the group of women, they are doing some ancillary activities also. Net making and mending, you know, that is actually being done in Jafarabad of Amreli district, Gujarat, and Navbandar in Bhavnagar district in Gujarat, and also Kakti, West Bengal, and Jagadishpur, Orissa. So what are the barrier and constraints for women participate and get the leadership? So first of all, actually, lack of recognition of the work. So actually, lack of recognition of work, you know, their works and the contribution in fisheries and aquaculture, you know, that is not recognized, particularly on the part of male fishers. And the notion that women do not fish, they are thinking that actually the women cannot do the fish. And the next one, the lack of information on contribution. Women's contribution and work, you know, actually, that is not recorded well. The absence of gender, the gender disaggregation, you know, in many employment statistics, it's not available. So one cannot know that someone actually achieved this, so we can move on. So the lack of information, you know, it is completely unacceptable. So we need to have a lot of statistics on this. Lack of integration of knowledge, the lack of integration of women's knowledge and experience, you know, this into fisheries management is completely, we are experiencing it. Women's perception, actually women's perception, you know, she himself think that fisher organizations are male domain. It is one of the biggest and biggest barrier to be to get them a leadership. And the personal barrier also, the lack of time, lack of confidence, and the scarcity of formal education. See, this, you know, this movement, some people think that the women are actually, women are usually seen as mothers and wives, while men are seen as breadwinners and leaders. We actually, most of the people are thinking like that. So, but women can do it. Still, the opportunities and careers are scattered equally for men and women only, not men alone. So actually, now we have seen the socio and economic status of women, and overall, actually, how to lift those women community as well as the entire human being, actually, entire people, especially women. So how to uplift them? So aquaculture and fishery sector, you know, this sector actually now gets very good boost from the government of India. So because very recently in February 2019, we have the government has created the Department of Fisheries, the separate Department of Fisheries. So by creating this, you know, by creating this, we believe that we can boost the boost and double the farmers' income and address the challenges of sustainability. The government has merged all the schemes of fishery sector into an umbrella scheme of blue revolution. Actually, very recently, everybody actually started to talk about the blue revolution, you know. So it is very important that all the schemes, the existing schemes actually merged with so one scheme called blue revolution, that is the integrated development and management fisheries. This is actually focusing on increasing fish production and productivity from aquaculture and fisheries resources. The creation of the separate Department of Fisheries, you know, it's a significant step done by the Government of India. The creation of Fisheries and Aquaculture Infrastructure Development Fund very recently was approved. The total fund size of 7,522.48 crores. NFDP and Blue Revolution scheme. See, NFDP concentrate on developing fisheries. There is intensive aquaculture in ponds and tanks, reservoir fisheries development, coastal aquaculture, mariculture, and seaweed cultivation, and infrastructure. When it comes to infrastructure, fishing harbor, the developing of fishing harbors and fish landing centers, fish dressing centers, and solar drying of fishes, domestic marketing, and deep sea fishing also. Ornamental fishes and other things. So it helps for technology of that technology of upgradation projects, human resource development program in fishery sectors, etc. From 2017, actually 16 and 17, the NFDP scheme has been subsumed in umbrella scheme Blue Revolution. And NFD is the major component of the restructured scheme. Actually, here there is no component wise specific outlay made, including for inland fisheries and aquaculture, as the scheme is actually this demand driven. So in 2015 to 2020, the amount of 3,000 crores budget has been approved and released. Again, FADF actually gives and funds for establishment of fishing harbors, fish landing centers, processing units for upgradation and new establishment. Fish transport, cold chain network infrastructure, ice plants, cold storage, any pre-processing centers, setting up broodstock banks, hatcheries, fish feed mills, plants, and fisheries development in reservoirs. Again, mariculture, seaweed cultures, and all those things, actually they are supporting and do it. Even the RAS, low cost RAS, also being supported by this FIDF. Surprisingly, renovation of MG NREGF, Mahatma Gandhi National Rural Employment Guarantee Act, you know, that's being ready for fish culture. The funding patterns, if you look at the funding patterns, the northeast and hilly states of the admissible subsidy, the state and the central share actually shall be as follows. The northeast and hilly states, 90% share actually comes from the central, and 10% comes from the state. Union territory, you know, 100% of share actually given by central only. Other states like Tamil Nadu and other Tamil Nadu, Gujarat, and all the states actually getting 60% of central and 40% from state. Total admissible government subsidy, you know, central and state put together, that will be 40% of the projects for general category, and 60% for, this is actually a valid point and very important point also, 60% of the project costs for weaker section like ACST, women and their cooperatives. The funding institutions, NFDB, NCDC, NABARD, and all federal banks and state fisheries departments are funding, are actually recommending to fund. So these are the funding agency we have to approach. And the detailed project, you know, so the project report, project proposal, that has to be reached. So if you want to start any business in fisheries and aquaculture, so you have to make a presentation and the proposal, and it has to be reached to the address given here. One has to go. So the joint secretary and New Delhi, you know, for one more series, and the copy has to be marked to the chief secretary. Note of contribution by government. As very recently, the government of India has sanctioned 1,840 crores up to August 18 to promote aquaculture and the fishery sector. And assistance provided for bringing almost 30,000 hectares of land under aquaculture. And they have sanctioned 89 numbers of landing centers, almost 199 number of RAS systems, installation of pens and cages in reservoirs and other pens, other open water bodies. Almost 7,600 approved, and the fish and prawn hatchery, you know, almost they approved 3,889 numbers. 380 units of post-harvest infrastructure facilities, that is ice plants and cold storage, has been approved, and they have trained almost 63,000 of fish farmers and other stakeholders. I think you may be knowing that the government of India allows 100 FDI, foreign direct investment in aquaculture through an automatic route, but actually controlled conditions. The government has been working towards the new projects. I can sense like blue revolution with the objective of developing wetland fisheries to empower communities and stakeholders through improved livelihood, and to define the refined religion region specific fisheries. Actually, you see in this point, you know, they actually by doing this we can refine region specific fisheries enhancements. Government of Indian seafood, you know, it has the potential of finding its place high in the global market. Okay, so the government of India's intervention along with the growing market and a conducive business and a regulatory ecosystem, India can definitely leverage this sector. It is where actually you see open new avenues investment and export. My view on near future is, you know, so by going through several articles and my reports, so this is actually happening. You know, the world is going to be happen. Well, the fish production, you know, that this one actually we have it will go up, and consumption parallelly that also, and the trade are expected to increase like anything. So what is our role? The India as a whole, Asia will continue to dominate the aquaculture, and the responsible for it is going to be an maximum responsible for 18% of the increase in production by 2030. And Africa also, so the sector is expected to expand up to 48%. So world food consumption in 2020 is projected to 18%. It's actually very much higher than 2018. So this is actually so what I wanted to tell you. So the last but not my least, the my presentation, you know, that is just a minute. Dr. Inbakandan?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. I'm not able to.
Click escape, sir. Escape.
There is a escape key. Vijay sir, escape nor key irukla, click pannunga velila vandralam. Or ninga edhavadhu or particular slide ponuma.
So veliye vandutan. Okay, is it okay to go move again?
Yes, sir.
You can go away.
Okay. So and the participants, actually, see, I would like to tell you one thing. Actually, see, so there are a lot of numbers. I have numbers, figures, tables, and those things. Actually, I have given. You know, this is not. I believe not enough to start the business. So we have to be patient and we have to work very smartly. So there is a saying, and so before that, I'll tell you one thing. That Mr. Jack Ma, the founder of Alibaba, you know. So so you know how big he is. He is to tell one thing. So which is actually impressed me and. So actually which I wanted to tell you, so when you work, so when you study in the school or college, so you just study well, okay, so you just study well and come out of school or colleges, start working with a small or any new startup where you can apply your ideas, views, and other things. So say if you start your career with any big concern, you know, you will be one among 100 or 1,000 or 1 lakh. So you have to select where you have to be and the place where you can find yourself potential. So work hard and work for some time, 4 years, 5 years, something. Actually, then you and see and be loyal to the company where you are working, then you just come out of company after four or five years of working there, you start a small company. Actually, company are big, it's actually up to your financial capacity, okay? And move on with the full strength, okay? So this is a thing actually, this is a thing I'm actually following it, okay? So I congratulate the participants to have a look on the swim culture. Those who are even come from other background, and got the very good knowledge by the help of those aquaculture intellectuals, and I'm very much happy that I'm actually part of this historic event. So last but not least, I would like to tell you guys that be safe in the pandemic time. So it is necessary you just to go out, do some work, otherwise stay back and be safe. God bless you all.
Thank you, Vijay sir. Thanks for the wonderful presentation. Almost you have narrated all the opportunities and career opportunities in the aquaculture, and you already you highlighted the point particularly about the women in aquaculture. And to this gathering, I want to inform that there is one expert in this aquaculture industry. She is a woman. She is Dr. V. Maria, who is nothing but Vijay's spouse. She is the director, best Aquastar Shrimp Hatchery, Marakkanam, Tamil Nadu, and she is the proprietor of Onyx Bioscience, Tuticorin. This shows that your respect towards women, sir. Thank you.
Because of her only, I can. I'm doing it actually.
Okay. To the participants, Vinith and Anu, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Actually, the thing is, I requested our director of research to join with us. We will just confirm that. Once you join, we start the valedictory session.
Yes.
Till the time, we can engage the in the question answer session.
Sure, sir.
Okay, kindly proceed with it.
Sure.
I think director of research, ma'am, is.
Yes, she is here. Sir. Yes, ma'am is here, sir.
Then we directly go to the valedictory session.
Yes, sir.
Ma'am, good afternoon, ma'am.
The ma'am hasn't connected to the audio, sir.
Yeah. Shall I ask her?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, please.
Are you sure she is not connected with the audio?
Yes, I am sure, sir. Ma'am is not connected.
Sir, yes ma'am, audio would have connected, please. Vijay sir, you can come out from this screen sharing option, sir.
Okay.
Ma'am, good afternoon, ma'am. You can unmute yourself, ma'am.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Please unmute yourself, ma'am. You can.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Vijay sir, screen sharing option la irundhu escape kuduthingana velila vandralam sir.
Still going on?
Yes ma'am. The program is session is over. Over, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, shall we?
Yeah, you can start with.
One minute. A warm good afternoon to one and all present here. It gives me immense pleasure to address the gathering and the validatory session of the six days virtual symposium on the recent trends in aquaculture industries, jointly organized by Colonel Dr. JPR Research Park Center for Ocean Research and Satyabhama University Technology Business Incubator in association with Ministry of Earth Science Technology Cell. First of all, I express my sincere thanks to our Honorable Chancellor Ma'am, Dr. Maria Gina Johnson, and President Sir, Dr. Marie Johnson, for their support. And they are continuing support in all the successful program, whatever we are doing in the online platform. I'm happy to welcome our Director Research Ma'am, Dr. B. Sheila Rani, who is being with us, even though in her busy schedule. I just want to bring the 6 days, 12 sessions to Ma'am here, as well as to the gathering here. As Center for Ocean Research is recognized by the Ministry of Earth Science for Marine Biotechnological Studies, and a ministry established the Earth Science Technology Cell at Colonel Dr. JPR Research Park at our campus. One of the objectives of the MOE's ESTC is to develop a common platform and create linkage with agencies, institutions, industries, on state, national, and international level for collaborative thoughts and to disseminate the idea on the augmentation of marine biological resources. As aquaculture and allied research is one of the focus area of Center for Ocean Research, this virtual symposium on the recent trends in aquaculture industries has been designed as per the objectives of the MOES ESTC. Apart from that, Satyabhama University Technology Business Incubator, functioning at Colonel Dr. JPR Research Park with the support of DST, National Science and Technology Entrepreneurship Development Board, that is NSTEDB. The main aim of our SUTBI is to promote marine resource-based products and technologies. Of course, we advise the young entrepreneurs planning for their startups on aquaculture, marine resource-based products and technology, value-added marine food resources, can visit Satyabhama University Technology Business Incubator and utilize the facilities offered by Satyabhama Institute of Science and Technology. Around 2,200 registration from 25 different countries. Of course, from our country, Bangladesh, China, Nepal, Tunisia, Israel, Mozambique, USA, Ethiopia, Portugal, Saudi Arabia, Sri Lanka, Singapore, Canada, Ghana, Nigeria, Spain, Indonesia, Philippines, Vietnam, Malaysia, and Qatar. This shows the success of this virtual symposium and the importance of the topics discussed during this session. Thank you. Thanks for every participant and your registration. Of course, the attraction point for this 6 day symposium is mainly due to the field experts in aquaculture industries who share their expertise in this platform for the benefit of the participant. On behalf of the management, I thank all the speakers. I personally thank Dr. Manoj Sharma sir, Dr. Abhinand Ravikumar sir, Dr. Chairan sir, Dr. Farzad sir, Dr. Suresh sir, Dr. Ravikumar sir, and Mr. Raj Manohar sir, Dr. Kadiravan sir, Dr. Jaykumar sir, Dr. Vijay sir, Dr. Salvakumar sir, and Mr. R. Sundar Rajan sir. Now I request ma'am to give the validatory note. Ma'am, please, ma'am.
Yeah. So good afternoon to all. Even this afternoon, I could see the number of participants, more than 231 participants are there and attending this virtual symposium. This shows really the way in which our convener, of course, Dr. Inbakandan sir and other co-conveners who have taken their full efforts in making this program a success. It is all a program, I can say it is in success means it all depends upon how people are really responding to it. That I could see even on the sixth day, almost today's last program, I think the presentation was over, we have come immediately to the valedictory session. I could see these many number of participants are there means, and I could see in the chat box also the people who are giving their comments. Really, I think the one which they have arranged this virtual symposium is a wonderful one. So see, this being a virtual symposium, and maybe we are all in this pandemic situation, we are going with these types of activities. Lot of online courses are being conducted. It could be a FDP program, or it could be some 1 month, 2 month certificate courses. Whatever maximum the participants would get benefited. Keeping that in mind, Sathibama and different research centers are organizing it. It is not only Center for Ocean Research. There are so many other centers on their own area of research. Every individual are organizing these types of virtual programs. But what I feel it is, right, for this period, nothing could be done. We are all into these types of programs. We are all learning theoretically. But when it comes to the practical one, this is a platform I should say to every individual, like at least for the people within India. I think these people have to take this opportunity, having understood what Sathibama could do it, having understood what Sathibama individual scientists have got their expertise also. So if they are capable of conducting these types of programs, and if they have the expertise, I think surely you must know it, that a good infrastructure is available with our Center for Ocean Research, and of course by the Sathibama Technology Business Incubator too. I think this is a very right platform. I have to invite every individual here. Somehow or other, try to make it come physically. Maybe once the situation gets over, I think people should utilize this opportunity and see to it that they come to Center for Ocean Research, utilize the facility. Say, unless otherwise things are in hands-on and meet one-to-one, certain things will not be very effective. Okay, rather than understanding from what is being given in book, we are all attending these types of virtual symposiums. But of course, this particular virtual symposium is more focused towards bringing experts from aquaculture industries. You may not get the chance even. So that chance they have given you for to get the speakers from the people who are working on spot in the aquaculture industry. So you might have heard whatever the way in which they are taking up and whatever the difficulties they would have faced it, everything, I think they would have shared it. Of course, I did not get the chance to attend all the speakers in the symposium, but still I can guess what would have been maybe on their expertise side, they would have spoken, and maybe Inbakandan sir was sharing with me that would be the way in which they have taken the industry also is going to be dealt, madam, is what he was telling. So that chance, you would not have got it if you have not attended this symposium. So having got that, but still I'm trying to invite you to Center for Ocean Research, and probably we are planning to go with one more online, not online, it is a 2-1 year PG diploma program. We are planning to start on aquaculture. So it is still in proposal fashion only, but DBT have encouraged us to submit a proposal on that. So probably we may go for that also, but still it has not been decided. It has the state government which has to give the approval, then only the central government will do it. So this time it's a joint hands of state government and central government. We are planning to take up this program. It's going to be a 1 year PG diploma course, wherein 6 months is going to be for a theoretical course and 6 months internship, wherein we will attach you with some aquaculture industry. So practically you have to take up that internship, and then we wanted to create ourselves as a job seeker for you. So that is all being planned. This is a modality that is being followed for one more PG diploma course, which we are running on fishery food products. So that is successful. Already 2 batches, almost I should say 75% of the students have been placed. In the 20 students we can admit. It's a DBT program. We have done it. So well, it was going on. So likewise, we are planning to conduct one more program. We are in the stage of submitting the proposal. We are planning to give it. So how far we are going to be successful in the proposal, I do not know. Even if it is not going to be the, because when we are doing it through DBT or through Tamil Nadu State Council, if we are doing it, okay, we have the brand name, we have with that, and we are going to do. Otherwise, as Sathibama University, if good response is there, we ourselves will start one PG diploma, because being a university, we have every possibility to start a PG diploma program. Because I could see here the participants' interest. If these many number of participants are going to are taking up this virtual program, means there may be a possibility that people may be interested in this 1 year PG diploma also, because such a wonderful infrastructure we have in Center for Ocean Research and in the associated aquaculture industry also. So this is one thing which I wanted to tell you. And my special thanks to all the speakers, right from Mayank Aquaculture and from Alpha Biological, from Shrimp Hatchery, Blue Aqua Group, and from Singapore, and then from Global Feeds, Aqua Connect, Then from Arctis Animal Health Center, C6 Shrimp Hatcheries, BMR Industries, Pilal Aquatics. See, in spite of your hectic schedule, you all have taken our, we have invited you, you all have come and you have given the lecture. First of all, my sincere thanks to the speakers. And second thing is sincere thanks to my convener, I should say. Really, the day you might have seen, all would have joined for the inauguration. This is conducted under the banner of Ministry of Earth Science, Earth Science Technology Cell. So in fact, almost there are more than 12 scientific steering committee members. Immediately after the inaugural function is over, every individual gave a note to me right from the top level of Ministry of Earth Science. They have given wonderful program you have organized, madam. So the credit goes to my convener only, I should say. Really, they have worked all at the last moment only. I just joined. I told, let us bring all of them inside this, because you are doing it along with the industry and you have got this many number of participants. And moreover, it is covering globally. So keeping that only, almost in 3 days, we have arranged. Everyone were very happy, and you might have seen the way in which they have addressed also. And after that also, we have got this, I have got specifically, they have congratulated me. So the congratulation goes to the speakers, goes to the conveners, and goes to the participants only, I should say. On behalf of them, I got all the congratulations. So that was one successful thing that has happened out of, because Center for Ocean Research conducts a lot of programs. It is not that they are going to stop with this. So immediately they are starting with the next program. So with their expertise, with their infrastructure, and with their enthusiasm, they are doing this many number of programs. I think the people who are here, the participants who are here, keep a watch always on our Satyabhama University website, particularly Center for Ocean Research website, to keep a watch and look for the programs that are going to be organized in a short period of time. Maybe this is a very right time you have to use the virtual programs. So we have time, we can utilize it also. So hereafter, we are going to go with flexible timings also, like maybe in the evening also, because some of the people say that we have all come out of this pandemic situation. Now we are all going to the office. So in such situation, but still without missing it, we want to attend. So planning to go with evening programs also, maybe after six, still if you have the energy, you can always sit and listen to these types of, you can attend all these types of virtual programs also. So once again, I thank the speakers, the convener, the participants, the convener and the co-conveners and whoever associated in this particular symposium. Everybody, I congratulate them. And especially the participants, till this moment, I could see there are 242 participants. I could see, generally people finish up and go immediately, okay, well, what is the need for valedictory note? But I could see the number of people who are still sitting for the valedictory also. It shows their immense interest. Thanks once again to all the participants. But finally, I would like to say, try to please come to our Center for Ocean Research as well as our Satyabhama Technology Business Incubator, which is more. In fact, this Technology Business Incubator, when we started in the year 2013, it was with the focus mainly on to promote marine resource-based products and technologies. So it was with that focus only we started. There are many startups, even though right now we might have grown up with engineering and technology, but still our main start was only with these types of, with our marine biotechnology only. So I think you have to visit our Satyabhama University and utilize our infrastructure resources. Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thanks a lot, ma'am. Ma'am, now I actually, Dr. Manoj Sharma sir is here with us, ma'am. Manoj Sharma sir, I request you to provide some feedback, sir. Please, sir.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you so much. It was very enlightening to listen to the ma'am also. But as a speaker and as a farmer and from the industry side, my really personal congratulations to Dr. Inba and the team. The way like 6 days they have done. And I think so far, amid COVID, I can rate this was one of the most successful virtual seminar and symposium you team have conducted. And not only the speakers, the best part of that is the way you have selected the speakers, given the titles, and also given them almost 2 hours in each and every speakers to come out with each and every expression. I generally don't like to come and speak for 15 minutes, Dr. Inba, because it will only be 15, 20 minutes only for me to warm up to come to that group. So really, really, when you gave me almost 1.5 hour, 2 hour with the interactions and all, and I on a record, I will tell you, this your recordings and YouTube sharings, this is going to help people coming in many, many, like 5 months, 6 months down the line. Anybody who is a little bit confused can go and link any topic of you and go through the expert views. And this will really help from right from workers to the faculty experts. Each and every point you have covered very nicely. And I wish that such more fruitful programs is we can expect from your COR team and Satyabhama team. Thank you, Dr. Inba, Anu Chandrasekhar, and each and everybody for your patience and 6 days marathon thing. God bless you all. This is in the interest of the country and this is in the interest of the nation. God bless you all. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Now I request Dr. Chairan, sir, who is also being with us. Sir? Chairan, sir?
Sir, please unmute yourself, sir.
Please unmute yourself, sir.
Sir, can you hear us, sir?
Chairan, sir, is it possible to?
I think he has some connectivity issues, sir.
Okay. Dr. Amrin Ravikumar, sir, is here. I request him also to join here.
No, sir.
He is not there.
It's not
so once again you just try with Chairan, sir.
Yes, sir, sure. So he has unmuted himself, but the audio is not working.
He is not there. Anyway, Kadravan, sir, are you there? Kadravan, sir?
Yes, sir. 1 minute, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
Hello.
Kadravan, yes, sir. Please.
Yeah, I'm there, sir.
Sir?
Hello.
Yeah, Kadravan, sir, you can share your...
sir, I think sir has also come in line.
Yeah, I still, he is not connected, ma'am. I just talked to him over phone.
Okay.
Yeah, actually, thank you, Dr. Inbagandan, conducting this great virtual symposium. Because as always, when the seminar or symposium conducted, people will take mostly from research area and any one topic from the our industry side. But this given a full complete set of from the hatchery to end of things, you are selected as a good speaker and everyone got a very good knowledge. I thank you very much and thank all the organizers from Satyabhama University. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Vijay, sir, you can share your views also, sir.
Audible?
Yeah, yes, sir, you're audible.
Actually, once again, it's a very, I would say, it's a very big event and it's an informative event also. Last 5 years, you put actually a lot of efforts to bring all fisheries intellectual on board. And I think they have, they explained each and every corner of fisheries and aquaculture sector. And so it is not a small event, Dr. Inba. So we are in the position to feed the entire world, actually. So it's our responsibility. So bringing the young blood into the aquaculture industry is our prime duty. So like me, as a new entrepreneur, I believe some number of people will definitely start this aquaculture as their career in the near future. So this all credit will go to Satyabhama University, the entire team. And a special thanks to Director Ji and for organizing such a wonderful event. And Inba Kandan, so I don't have more words to say because he put a lot of energy last for 5 days to bring all the industries. Actually, still at the middle of my my talk, actually I went somewhere because actually local issues and also actually came in. And that's why I actually got the energy. So, okay, anyhow, see, bringing all industrialists, you know, to participate and let other people know their view. You know, it is a big thing. So you have done really very good job, and keep doing it. God bless you all, and thank Inbakandar once again. Thanks a lot.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Vinith, can you connect to Chairman, sir?
Yes, sir. So he hasn't joined yet, sir.
Okay, sure. Okay. Shejadri, sir, is there?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Sir?
I'm there, sir. I'm here, sir.
Yes, sir. Please, sir. Please, sir.
Good afternoon, everyone. This is a wonderful week. We spent almost 7 days with the 12 speakers. That's a very video. Okay, sorry. So this is a wonderful week we spent. Almost all the lectures were coined very specifically, and everyone has done the justice for the titles also. And the one thing the takeaway from this program is more important. I see a larger possibility for us to create a consortium of industry, academia, and entrepreneurship consortium formed, so that we can help as many entrepreneurs as possible. That's one thing. And second thing, as our director of research rightly pointed out, this also will help position most of the students attending these programs into jobs, and also help them to stand on their own legs. So shortly, I think there is a possibility, again, as the research said, we will be starting another program that will be reaching out to as many younger generation people, that means the younger budding entrepreneurs as possible, and also help them to nurture themselves to go to the next level. It is something like exposing them to the industry and also the academia, and also helping them to acquire some kind of technologies, and also putting them with on the track of even learning what is business, what is entrepreneurship, how to take things forward and move to next level. So maybe the ministry also can be of help to us in this area. So if that is there, everything will be fine. I hope shortly we will be reaching out to as many people as possible. And the Center for Ocean Research can take a larger lead in this area of, promoting entrepreneurship through this maritime based activities. I think with this, I stop. Thank you so much, and thank you for the opportunity. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. I think Dr. Vitra Chandrasundari, sir, is with us. Can you unmute him?
Actually, sir, is not. 1 minute, sir. I can't see him, sir, in the chat box, in the participant list.
Okay. Selva, Dr. Selva, are you there?
Yes, sir.
Please, please.
Dr. Selva Kumar, sir. Yes, sir, please.
Sir, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
Sir, actually, you have created a very good platform to impact the aquaculture expertise all over the industry, sir. So we are very happy to join with you to share our knowledge in particular expertise area. So overall, Satyabhama University doing a very good interaction programs like this. I feel personally it's a very fruitful sessions to all the people. Mostly students, community people are participants are very high, I think so, in this program. They will definitely get benefit out of it. I thank you to all the participants as well as the organizers. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Dr. Selva. I think, ma'am, we can allow one or two participants to.
Very well. Let them give the feedback. We could see they're all asking for feedback link, please.
Yeah.
Feedback,
yes, ma'am, we have already created the feedback link, but I asked some of them to give the feedback here.
Very well.
Any of the participants, if you want to share your review here, you just raise your hand. Chairman sir is there, you just unmute him.
Yes, sir. So please unmute yourself, sir.
Chairman, sir? Yeah. Sir, you can.
Yeah, hear me?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
So, you know, I came to Hatchery and there are some connectivity issues. It's a remote. Okay. It's very well. Well done, Edbakandan. Madam was telling, I was hearing all the things. It is an excellent, bringing the people together for the, sake of juniors and youngsters, for the young entrepreneurs, everything is done excellently. But only what the difference I could see, you know, because who was there in the inaugural session, who are all the experts talk about, what are all these points are missing. There is a connectivity issue. Because all the experts could not be able to see the every program. If every program is there, is a link.
You
had to make that link, and before they come to that, you know, university. Yeah.
Sorry for the interruption. I think there is some connectivity problem is there, sir. You can just repeat the thing.
Okay. Yeah, that is what I was trying to say. Am I hearing? Able to hear me now?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, what I was telling, you know, the inaugural session, Professor Balasubramaniam, he was my teacher when I was doing PhD. And then I didn't know, he inaugurated. Later on only I could see that. And then ARTSR was talking and some of the DBT people, our earth science experts were all talking. So after that only I could see. So the thing is, whatever the inauguration part happened, everyone, if they come to know, it will be more effective in that presentation. And it will be utilized for the valedictory also. So who are all the experts joined? Most of the people are, participated in the valedictory also. It's very good. And whatever the message, we will take it in for the further development. I wish you very much congratulations to all. And it is very much, the university has done excellent in this thing. The team, including the madam, talked about all this. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot, sir. Actually, the thing is, we have requested all the advisors and our mentors, but they said due to their busy schedule, they said,
okay,
as it is on YouTube, they are watching us through our YouTube, sir. That's what I want to inform you here, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Didn't you allow any one of the participants to talk if they raise their hands?
Yes, sir. We have raised hands. Mr. Praveen Prasad, you can. Mr. Praveen Prasad, if you wish to interact, please unmute yourself.
Yeah. This session is very good and I go through this whole session. But I request all the person, if you share this all PPT for our reference, that is very good. We noted lot of things, lot of new technology things. Lot of things. I'm very thankful because I am from Delhi, and through this platform I learn lot about the aquaculture and what is the future scope of the aquaculture. I'm very thankful to everyone, host and Anuji and other people, and they are very informative also about that. When we chat something, they reply. That is very good. But last is all PPT, if you share to the registered mail ID of this all participant, that is good, so that we can use that PPT for a present and future reference.
Thank you, Praveen. Actually, the thing is, the YouTube link is having all the presentations. You can view the presentation at any time in the YouTube link, which is already given to you. Anyway, as per your request, we are ready to share the entire session's link in the particularly when you are getting the certificate, we will send the link to you, to everyone.
Okay, thank you, sir.
Ma'am, shall we end the session here, ma'am?
Some one or two more, they have raised hand. Just
yes, ma'am, yes, ma'am. Yeah.
Rakesh Jinamani.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Mr. Rakesh Jinamani can speak.
Hello, good afternoon, everyone.
Good afternoon.
First of all, I want to thank you all the organizer committee of Satyabhama Institute and all the speakers who have enlightened my knowledge in aquaculture field. Specifically, I want to tell you that I am belong to engineering background, but still I am interested in fish farming. That's why I am entered in this field. But before entering, I only thought that shrimp and fish are the aquaculture species. But here I came to know that all the means like seaweeds culture and lots of nutrition and everything you have taught in this 6-day seminar totally enlightened my knowledge in this regard, and that will help lots of farmers because I am also a freelancer and I am giving free trainings to my local farmers so that they can earn something and they can maintain the nutritional value in their daily life. So thank you all for this webinar, and I am very thankful to Satyabhama Institute. So thank you, please.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you, Rakesh. Thank you. You can unmute the person who is in the...
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. So please unmute yourself and share the knowledge, share the information, sir. Yes, please, sir.
Good afternoon, everybody, especially to Satyabhama Institute. Hello.
Yes, sir. You are audible.
We can
sir,
hear
please.
You.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you. And especially, Madam Sheila, Madam. Actually, I am from the electrical industry, but since just before COVID, we decided to enter this fishery department because my industrial business was fishing. I am basically from West Bengal, but I stay in Mumbai. We are planning on 100 tanks, 55,000 liter tanks for going into this thing. And I was very happy to hear Mr. Manoj sir. And actually, I want to get in touch with him. And also, what is the SIBA? I have written some mails, but there is no answer from, maybe due to COVID. I expect now, after attending this session, all these 6 days I was available. I'm so enlightened, and thank you. And definitely we want to, do something so nice for our nation so that, we create employment, general employment, and do, I've learned this BioFlock, and since I'm not 6-7 months, I'm just learning. But now we want to go into action. And thanks a lot for this very educative session. I rest myself. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
There is just only one more person who had raised hand to see AA21D97.
Yes, sir.
We will unmute him. 1 minute.
Sir.
Hello.
Yeah, please.
Hello. Hello, I'm special thanks to Satyabhama University to organize a nice, wonderful symposium. And basically, I'm earlier working in aquaculture sector. Now working in Gujarat Institute of Desert Ecology scientist. Now I'm working in seaweed cultivations. So basically, our project is related to livelihood enhancement of coastal community of cods. So in that regards, we are working on that, implementing that projects. So when I go through this detailed information, I'm very happy to that such type of information is delivered by Satyabhama University. And a special thank to Imakandan sir and madam and all the organizing team to such nice and abundant for arrangement for this event. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Dr. Imakandan.
Yes, sir. Welcome, sir. Dr. Victor.
I was some problem with my mic and camera.
Yes, sir. But we are hearing you, sir. Please, sir.
I could not call also in mobile and all because you are all on the platform, that's why. So usually I used to have a sleep for about 1 hour after lunch, but today I have kept myself awake because it was just to appreciate that it was really a wonderful 5 days program. Webinar for 5 days, it's not an easy job. So you people have done fantastic work. And the thing is you have pulled in all the big shots in aquaculture, particularly those who are in the field, like Manoj Sharma, Charan, Vijay. It's nice. So whatever the information they shared, definitely it will be useful for the youth. And hope there will be much more programs even after COVID, as Madam Director Search was telling. There should be some good program. We have access of coastal area. We can do wonders. I think yesterday I already discussed with Dr. Imbagandan also about seaweed farming and all. So let's hope to see much more progress in aquaculture, coastal aquaculture particularly. Thank you.
Thanks a lot, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Ma'am, shall we end the program, yes, ma'am?
You can just...
Before that, Anu and Vinit, please share the feedback link to the participant.
Yes, sir. Yes, I'm sharing it, sir.
Yeah.
Participants, you can...
The feedback link is in the chat box. Kindly use of it.
Kindly post your feedbacks in that feedback form.
After the successful submission of feedback form, e-certificate will be issued to all the participants within 10 to 15 days, positively.
And once again, I thank our Director of Research, ma'am. And thanks to Dr. Manoj sir, as well as Chairman sir, everybody. Just now only I messaged them and requested them to join here. And thanks for your immediate response and joining us and sharing the few words with us, sir. Thanks a lot. And thanks to our ma'am, Director of Research, ma'am. Because of her support only, we are doing such kind of program. Thanks to the ma'am. And Dr. Sheshadri sir, because in Singapore, particularly that Dr. Farshad sir, he only connected to Blue Aqua International and he Blue Aqua in association to this symposium. And sir also having some other viewpoint in his during this talk, he said we have some other idea also to go ahead there. So following by this symposium, we want to continue in another program, and shortly we will, with the permission of our management, will shortly announce to the participant through your mail. Thank you. Thanks, sir. Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir. Thanks to everybody.
Thank you all.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, participants.
Please share the feedback link.
Yes,
and
sir.
We also
have shared, sir.
And another thing, we will share the feedback link to your register email ID also. So please don't worry if you are not.
The Nipah virus, say, jaipatharku endru sollapatta oru vishayam.
Sorry, sir.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you, everyone. We can leave the meeting now. Thank you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you,
sir.
Yes.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you all.